Cool, so you've got your bee box, and hopefully in the bee box I've sent you some frames, and there you've got to put the frames together. I mean, sometimes you buy them and they come already made, but as a general rule, frame construction is one of the jobs that us beekeepers spend a fair bit of time, most often in winter, and a whole lot of panicking going on in spring. So you're going to have to get organised and make your frames up. You're going to get a top bar, you're going to get a bottom bar, and you're going to get a couple of spacers. These are full depth frames. You can have the ideals or half depths, but for the brood box, you want a full depth frame. Well, I believe you do. Mind you, there are some beekeepers that use half frames and all the stuff, but don't worry about that. Just get the jolly things put together. So these actually have your spaces, so you get your bee space organised. So you'll come in there and they're actually beautifully designed. You can make your own. I mean, hell, if you're into woodwork and you want to make your own bee frames, that's fine. But please go online and get the measurements right, because it's a real pain in the bum when they're not quite the same size. I got a lovely lady that her dad had made her a bee box, and she wanted to actually buy some bees to put in the bee box. She'd been trying to catch a swarm for a while and nothing had happened. So I said, yeah, no, that's fine. I bring the box home and I cleaned it all up and got it all organised, and then I went to put the newt box in the box, but the frames don't fit. So that was like, ah, man. So then I had to put a swarm in there instead, which is fine. But if you're going to make it, go online, get the measurements for your country and make the damn things all the same size, because it's just going to make your life easier going forward. Because if you've got one bee box or two bee boxes, next thing you know, you're going to have 20 bee boxes. And you want them all to be the same size, because it's a real pain in your bottom if it's not. Now, I thought I'd use some nails. I've got a nail gun here. I mean, I make thousands of these things. But I thought, you know, if you're in your backyard, you don't need a nail gun. You don't need to get all excited. All you need is a hammer, some nails, and a little bit of glue. And you tickety-boo, away you go. So here we are. So you put your bottom board on the bottom, of course. Ha! Ah, your bottom board on the bottom. Yeah, that would be logical otherwise, wouldn't it? And I normally like to put a little bit of glue in here, and you slip that on your bottom board, and a little bit of glue on that one, like this. And you slip that together. And then you want to put a little bit of glue in here, and a little bit in there. Now, of course, if you don't happen to have any Aquadeer, it's not completely imperative that you glue them together. I think it's just to make them all a little bit more sturdy going forward. Because you put a fair bit of pressure on, once you get these in your beehive and you get your hive tool up here, you put a lot of pressure to get this, because it would be quite a bit of propolis, a bit of honey, a bit of goodness knows wax. And if you're really unlucky, you'll have wax moss up the side. That's a whole nother episode. But anyway, so you want to have them pretty sturdy. So I got some half reasonable nails, 2 millimeters in the thickness and 30 millimeters in the longness. You don't want them too short, you don't want them too skinny or too fat, because otherwise it just split your bloody frame in half. If you're really lucky and you've bought a kit, they're probably going to turn up with some nails. But you know what? If they didn't, there you go. I got my high-class hammer. Well, I don't know how high-class it is. I'm sure there's someone out there who's a woodworking person who's going to say, you can't use that hammer to blow and put nails in them. You're supposed to use the claw hammer thing. But just for all the people out there that are excited, my poor claw hammer's older than me. So look, she's a little bit wonky-donk, and I haven't gone into the house to steal the wife's nice hammer, so we're stuck with this one. And it's just nice, it's a nice weight. And yes, technically it's not a nail hammer, it's a blooming beating up tin hammer, but you know what? Do as I say and don't do as I do. I think that's what I used to say to my kids. And and this just goes on and on and on. The nailing and the nailing and the hammering and the nailing. Oh my gosh. But hopefully you only have to make 20 of them, so you'll be right. You just want to make sure it's reasonably square. You can put them in a jolly holder and get all excited. And you don't need to get quite as excited as some people do with their blooming squares and making sure it's all perfect. But you know what? If you wish to, you can. Just make sure to hit the damn nail straight. That would be good. That would be a good start, wouldn't it? Now, if you're going to use plastic foundation, I like to put a little clout in either end here. I've got a little tack that I like to put in here, mainly because if you put plastic foundation in here and that happens to be full of honey, all the weight ends up on your bottom board. And so it'll fall out and you'll be walking back to your extracting plant or your wheelbarrow or whatever, and this bottom board lets go and then the plastic foundation sheet full of honey goes on the ground straight into the bloody ryegrass and, oh heaven, worse than that, into the cow pad. And then, you know, all that hard work the girls put in and you put in is all wasted. So this is a little trick for young players. So I like to just put a little tack in there. You don't want it to be too big because otherwise you'll split this bit of wood. Because you can see here it's fairly fine. You can see here it's fairly fine. You don't want to split that in half, otherwise you're blooming defeating the purpose. Right, beautiful. And then you just throw it over here on the pile and you just keep doing that and on and on and on and on. Now, these are little brass inserts. Now, if you didn't happen to get any brass inserts in your blooming kit that's turned up, don't freak out, it's okay. The idea is that when you wire up your frames, the idea of the little brass bit is so as it doesn't tear the wood and then your wire starts getting looser and looser. But you know what? Honestly, if you're only doing this and you're starting out, just relax. It's going to be okay. Especially if your bees are turning up tomorrow. Don't stress about actually whether or not you've got any brass endy bits. It just makes your frames work longer and your wire won't get so flat. I bought this little jolly, supposed to be an applicator, but I'm not really sure whether it's good or bad or indifferent, but it does make the life a bit easier. Yes, anyway, there's all these little fiddly little bits that go towards making your beehive a bit more user-friendly. I just like to tap them in a little bit so they are a little bit firm. Now all I've got to do is find out where I put the wire that I ordered. There's some wire somewhere in this blooming disorganized little workshop. Now, I've made this daggy little bit of wire applicator up, mainly because sometimes you get these spools that turn up from the bee people and you blooming open up the glad wrap that's around them and the wire just goes pling and you have a hell of a mess. But if you haven't got one of these, don't stress. It's not imperative. It just saves a lot of drama. I reckon I put it in a plastic container, something like that, and then it wouldn't actually just unspool as you pulled it off. So you can find a container the right size, just stick it in that. That works as well. All these possibilities. Right, and then we just want to push the wire through. So this is pretty self-explanatory, I would have thought. You just go backwards and forwards. Try not to get it kinked, because otherwise, being that it's stainless steel, it'll break, and then you'll have all sorts of excitement. And if you've bought a kit, you've probably only got the exact amount of wire that you need. I mean, I got miles of this stuff laying around, so I can have a few mistakes and get away with it. I don't know. I've never actually just bought a single kit. I guess one day going forward, we might have to have a bush bee man backyard bee kit. But I don't know. We haven't got that far yet. One thing at a time. Anyway, you just want to pull that through, pull that there. Make sure it's about the right width. Now, there's a few different options when you get to the tying off part. You can just whip that around there and tie it back around itself. Me, I'm still a bit old school, so I use a tack. If you put a little tack down the bottom, just push that into your wood. Give it a little, just tap it in a little bit. Now, a trick for young players, don't get massive big tacks because otherwise you split the jolly frame in half and that's a real pain in the bottom. Just whiz the wire around the tack a bit like that. And once you've got it around it, tap that down. Trim off this excess. So as the girls don't poke their eye out, because that could be a bit awkward. Right, and now, when you want to tension it up, you just get your finger in this gap here, and then when you get that nice and tight, you pull that tight. There is special frame wiring bits you can buy, which we can show you later, but this is just if you haven't got all that stuff. Just pull it tight and put your thumb on there and bend it over. Pull that one through, and if you actually bend your wire a little bit and put your finger on it, you'll pull it nice and tight. Just pull that one as well and bend that before you let it go. Then you're going to have this one. It's going to be nice. Pull that around. And then you're going to snip it off. You probably could have got motivated and put another tack in the top. But that's all right. Tack that down there. Pull that up nice and tight so you got that going pretty good. and whiz it around your next tack. Nail that down, and there you have it. Just trim that little bit off. And of course, if you change your mind about being a beekeeper, you can go and serenade your wife now. Love, thee will be some honey soon, darling. Right, now, after you've got your 10 of these done, next thing you need to do is put your wax on. A bit like the Karate Kid, wax on, wax off. Now, there's a few different options for putting wax on. You can buy a, hang on, I'll see if I can find it for you. I haven't used this for a while. Where did I put that, John? Actually, maybe it's out at the farm, I think. So, no, we can't show you that. You can buy a little, it's called an electrode, like it gets the wire hot, and then it melts the wax. I'm terribly unprepared and haven't got one here, but anyway, you'll see that online. There's plenty of them. Or you can be ingenious like me. And I actually made my own in better. So all I did on this little exercise is I got some aluminium, which apparently conducts electricity quite well, so I found out. And I just bent this around, cut that off, I used some little bits of old B-frame that I had laying around. So cut that the right size so as that measures across there. And then I've just hooked it to a 12-volt battery, which is underneath there. Obviously positive one side, negative the other side. Don't hook them both together, otherwise, you know, your battery will go flat. That's a bit pointless. And then it's very nice, you see, you sit your frame on the top, you put your bit of wax in, you try to get the wax in that hole, it sits in there nicely. And then, obviously, you've got positive and negative, so you're going to create a current. And you just, and it just heats up the wire, which heats up the wax. Just be careful when you heat up your wire that you don't get it too jolly hot, otherwise it'll cut straight through the wax and you'll have nothing. Mind you, if you're into natural beekeeping and you don't want to get all of this exciting, you can actually have just a small strip along here and the girls will build the rest of it out. This just saves them some time and makes it all orderly. So when you want to pull things apart, you'll actually have things in a nice, organized, easy to manage hive. So there you go. If you don't happen to want to go to all the trouble of making one of these, you can buy yourself a little wheel like this, which I haven't found that to be terribly successful, except you have to have the wax at the right temperature for this project. If your wax is too hot, the jolly stuff gets stuck on the wheel and it's a real blooming nuisance. But if the wax is the right temperature, the shed's doing the right thing, these are quite cool. So you've got your wax foundation that you've bought or made, maybe if you got really motivated. And then there's this cute little divot in the top bar that you need to slip the wax into so as you get it in the right spot. So you just got to make sure it sits in there nice. And this is the fun part, is actually getting it to go in a straight line. So hopefully you've got a bit of the right light, just the right amount of excitement. Now, of course, if you don't happen to have one of them, don't despair. Because all you need to do is you put your finger at the back of the wire on both sides and you just give it a little, bit of enthusiasm. Like, so you put one finger at the back, one finger at the front, and just push it on. And it actually works really good if you haven't got all these other fancy resources. Ultimately, the girls are going to cover this and make it a proper honeycomb. And so it's not really going to matter. But what you don't want is if you don't get this to stick together and you put it in your hive and it's a little bit warm, the bloody wax will roll over and then you'll come back and you'll have the girls will have built wherever the wax is and it ends up a jolly mess. So that's what you're trying to avoid. If you're wondering why you've got to do all this excitement to get your wax to sit on the wires nicely, you want them to, because when your nuke turns up, you're going to have five frames that you'll put in there and then these frames will be a little bit further afield. So they won't get filled up straight away. They're not that clever. So they're going to take a little while to fill out. So you just need to make sure your wax is a bit stable so as that it doesn't end up a hell of a mess going forward. The thing with most of this beekeeping stuff, it's all about avoiding what can happen tomorrow. So it's avoidance and it's planning. And you've got thousands of little insects that rely on your ability to have a good plan. Now, of course, If you happen to not be bothered of making frames and you just can't be stuffed, there's a really cool company called Barnett Beekeeping Supplies, and this is how they turn up. Look, you just get a box of 20, and I can whip the lid off here. If I can find a knife, would be even better, but let's not get too carried away. Let's not make the show look too bloody organized. And they just turn up, and you just pop them out of the box of 20, and there they are. Look at that. Hey, presto. Got the little bloomin' brass bits put in, which is my pet hate. Got your tacks. Now, of course, there's frames online as well that can be bought, but be a little bit cautious. I have as a trick for young players, I bought some frames from they weren't Australian, they were from a different country, and the bloody wire that they'd used wasn't even stainless steel wire, so they just rusted out within jolly, 6 months or less, which was most annoying. So if you're only buying bloomin' 20 frames, please just at least put your money towards something that's decent. Like, golly gosh. I was buying thousands, and so I was trying to save a dollar. But you know what? What is it? What do they say? Sometimes what you get is what you pay for. That's life's motto, isn't it? Cool. So now you've got your frames. You've got your bee box. Hell, now all you got to do is pick a spot to bee. I wonder if that's a double EB. So if you're coming along on this journey and you're enjoying watching us teach you how to be a beekeeper, why don't you go onto the Patreon support page, which is just down here somewhere, and click a link and it'll take you through. And if you give us $10 a month, look out. You can become part of the live Q&A and become part of the Bush Bee Man family. Let's grow this online community of beekeepers so we can all interact and help each other grow and enjoy the passion that we've all found with insects in a box.